And welcome to Coffee Talk. Grab yourself a cup of coffee and come on and join us. Today, our first official guest, I am thrilled to be speaking with Faith Taylor, the director of MITE, the Montclair Institute for Global Human Trafficking. MSU people will most remember MITE for their Blue People project last year, those life-size blue cutouts of people who were all over campus and represented victims of human trafficking. In addition to her work with MITE, Faith has taught courses on sustainability and innovation in MSU's Feliciano School of Business. Now, prior to being here at MSU, Faith has a very impressive CV. She worked for Wyndham Worldwide for 15 years as Senior Vice President, Corporate Social Responsibility Officer. That's a mouthful, and she probably had plenty of work to do. A VP of Marketing, Innovation, and Product Development, focusing in areas of branding strategies, diversity, ethics and responsible sourcing, hotel prototypes, how cool is that? Human rights, interior designs, philanthropy, sustainability, and wellness. She was acknowledged by the Obama White House with the Obama Better Business Recognition in 2014. She was recognized by the National Diversity Council as one of the most powerful women in the industry, and in 2015 by the Network Journal as one of the 25 most influential Black women in business. In 2016, NJ Biz magazine included Faith on the list of the most powerful women in New Jersey. And in 2018, April, she was presented with the Women in Leadership Award by the Boy Scouts of America. She sits on the boards of the New Jersey Performing Arts Center and Executive Women of New Jersey. Faith holds a BA in psychology and economics from Stanford and an MBA in marketing from the Wharton School of Business at the University of Pennsylvania. It is my great pleasure to welcome to Coffee Talk, Faith Taylor. You've had a really, really impressive career, and you have many inspiring awards and honors. I think I said to you earlier that I was very impressed as I was reading through that. But what brought you to MSU?
So I was an adjunct professor at MSU while I was at Wyndham Worldwide as a chief corporate social responsibility officer. And I always believe in giving back. So I was teaching a course at night on sustainability and innovation. And I did that for several years. And then when I left Wyndham, because Wyndham basically divested their huge global conglomerate and now is two separate companies that are much smaller. And at that time, the dean actually approached me and said, would you consider being a full-time professor? And I said, you know what? That is absolutely something I would love to do. I'm a firm believer in going for your passion, and Montclair State University has been incredible. The students are incredible, and they remind me of my background. I'm a military brat. My mother's Japanese. My dad's African-American. And so my first language was not English, it was Japanese. I was born in Japan. And when we came to the United States, I had to help my mother, who could not read or write English, and I helped her while we were here, and my dad was stationed overseas. So you can imagine, I was one of three girls. And that humble beginning and really working hard in school, I used to help her clean people's houses. And then eventually I got a scholarship to Stanford University and then went to get my MBA at Wharton. So I'm one of those kids who was a scrapper who had to learn how to really take initiative. And that's what I've, that background to me, I feel like that's the opportunity that I have at Montclair State University versus going to a private school.
What from the work that you did before MSU informs and guides your courses and your work with MITE?
So what's really interesting is that my work in corporate social responsibility was overseen for the global enterprise. We were in 120 countries, and we had over 200,000 locations around the world, hotels, timeshares, rental exchange. And we worked in partnership with so many companies. And the key areas that I was responsible for was what you said, sustainability, philanthropy. And human trafficking actually was something that went all the way up to our board of directors, because there's legislation, for example, called the Modern Day Slavery Act, which is out of the United Kingdom. There's legislation here in the United States and around the world about companies and what are you doing to prevent human trafficking? And if you have an issue, how are you managing it? So I worked with several organizations like Polaris, like ECPAT, which are global entities, and with my industry to develop solutions. And that's everything from policy, working at the, federal level to the local state, and actually implementing at our locations training, education, and a hotline, and all of the things that you have to do tactically to actually prevent and mitigate human trafficking. So when I was here and I had the opportunity to work with one of our benefactors at the Feliciano Business School. And we actually, she was very interested and very passionate about this. And I said, I can actually help you do that. And so it's been since 2018 that a group of incredible faculty here at Montclair State University, we started just a coalition, multidisciplinary across the university. And it was done out of passion. And it was, we were not getting paid for this. And it was above and beyond what we, typically do in terms of teaching and all of the programming that we do. But it's because people have a commitment because they care. And I find that those are the best initiatives to start from the ground up. And my background at Wyndham Worldwide, I created my job. So it didn't exist. And I remember it was the recession of 2008. And I had the opportunity to talk to my chairman because we were spinning off from a larger conglomerate to become a hospitality division. Before we had car rentals, we had online travel portals, and it was a huge conglomerate. We had real estate. And so when we spun up hospitality, I had the opportunity to talk with my chairman because I worked on some other projects. And I said, you really need to be concerned about sustainability and green for the company. And, at that time, my son came to me and said, oh, mom, have you seen this movie, Inconvenient Truth by Al Gore? And I was like, what? And my son Jordan said that to me, and I said, well, I don't know. He goes, mom and dad, please go see it. So I did go see it that weekend, and the light bulb went off because I was working on, as you said, I was in marketing, I was developing new prototypes. In that new prototype, when I was working with Michael Graves, the architect and designer, we knew that the consumer was going green. So we were incorporating into the actual prototypes, from the sheets to the bedding to the type of coffee to the actual experience when you walk in, to having light, to looking at LEED certification. All of that was part of the prototype development. When I saw this movie, it clicked to me that this is a corporate edict, that you are going to have to be concerned about how you manage your footprint, how you actually go about doing that. And I said, I know, I'm not a fortune teller, but I said, this is going to be strategic to the company. I told him that. And I told him to go see the movie. And at the end of the day, what is also great about, his name is Steve Holmes, the chairman of the company, is that he came back to me 3 months later and said, why don't you start that? Now, he's a Republican, I'm a Democrat, but we have the same values. We have the same concern for the environment. So when I started, he said, you're going to start this program with no money, and you're going to do it with what you're doing today. And I looked at him like, you've got to be kidding me. But I took the challenge on. And for that first year, I worked with all of these different groups around the world and put together a strategic plan, went back to him and said, you need to do this program and I'm going to do it for you. So I started with just me, an administrative assistant, and over the next 12 years, we grew the program to be a global enterprise that was actually, we were the world leader in hospitality. So I understand the concept of going for your passion and building a program over many, many years and asking for resources, but delivering huge impact. And so we were able to save almost $100 million in energy expenses. We were able to give away $50 million in foundation programs. We were able to, develop human trafficking training that was rolled out across the entire United States under the American Hotel Lodging Association. And it was for free because a lot of middle to small enterprises couldn't afford the training. So we did it under that. So there were so many things that we were able to do. And I feel that I was blessed to have that opportunity to do it. But I do want to say that it was not easy. And as an African American woman in this space, a lot of times people would be like, oh, do you have your doctor's in engineering? Oh, and I said, no. And they were like, well, I said, I just taught myself. I listen. I work with people that I believe in. You always work with an incredible team of people. And together, the program was built really by the people in the company. And it was built from the ground up. So that's what has informed me as we're looking at this human trafficking initiative and now to be center, because, 2 years ago, we talked about it. Now it's going to be a center. So I understand the concept of having an idea, turning it into a concept, but most importantly, developing the program that has an impact on people and industries. And so that to me is exciting, and I'm happy to be here.
So before I get on, I want to talk to you about my, and I want to talk to you about the center. But before I do that, you mentioned a lot about green, and Montclair has, in the past, had a rather significant recognition regarding its greenness. Isn't that right?
Absolutely. Working with the PSE&G Institute here and Amy Tanuga, they've done an incredible job. And I've actually taught to the program over the last several years on corporate social responsibility and also how do you apply metrics to the solutions that they provide to corporations and nonprofit groups. So the footprint, Montclair State has really taken the lead in that area, developing LEED certified buildings, developing alternative energy sources, and really taking the lead in research in that area. There is a huge opportunity to continue with that as we move forward, especially the social responsibility side of that, because when you're implementing the programs, it is about the people.